Hi, everybody. Welcome in. It's Laura from Tenacious Taurus Twin Flame Tarot, and this is going to be the daily message for November the 1st. It's a brand new month, fresh new energies. I'm excited to see what kind of a message needs to come through today for the collective. If you have not already, do feel free to hit that subscribe button to join the channel to never miss an energy update. And let's jump right in and see what kind of a message needs to come through today. What kind of a message needs to come through for the collective today? We'll see the main energies. What kind of a message needs to come through? We got divine timing. This is a powerful day for the opening of the new moon portal, the eclipse portal gateway. So I think whatever is happening, it is definitely happening in divine time. And I think get ready for a paradigm shift. It's kind of time to release any outdated belief patterns, any ineffective energies in and around you, to really step into perhaps your spiritual calling, spiritual places. I think it's kind of time to retreat, to go deep within your own spiritual place, within your heart. And I think it really is time for you to rejuvenate your mind, your body, and your spirit. So connection is key, and chakra balancing. So where are you needing to tune up your chakras in order to maximize the energy that's flowing through you in order to bring you to a state of overall well-being? So get ready for a shift. And I do think forgiveness is going to be key in the energy. So where are you needing to offer forgiveness? Because when you step into the energy of forgiveness, it not only liberates your own heart from pain, it also liberates another. So let's see what else needs to come through when it comes to this message today. I'm pretty sure I saw the throat chakra. So I do think light is being shed on a situation when it comes to this shift. Third eye. I was close. It's almost the same color. So I think a lot is coming through when it comes to seeing clearly truth. I think where are you needing to get really honest with yourself? It is this energy of judgment, a final judgment call needing to be made. And I just noticed 222, which is all about decisions and crossroads. So I feel a lot is being illuminated. Maybe you need to clear some third eye chakra blockages. But I do feel this higher level of education, stepping into a spiritual commitment, you know, stepping into honoring your spiritual journey and get it rooted in a daily practice. So let's see what needs to come through with the tarot when it comes to this message today. 5. So I do think get ready for change. 19 is a karmic debt number associated with the fall of the ego. So where are you kind of harboring any resentments, you know, from the ego that really have prevented you from stepping forward? So I do think a release is needed. I think maybe get ready for a battle when it comes to the energies today. We do have the Knight of Pentacles, the Seven of Wands, and the Devil. So there is a toxic belief pattern or an addiction or something here that is very negative needing to be addressed in the energies. And I do feel the time is now. We have a couple of sevens. Sevens truly are the number from heaven. It is the number of the mystic. So I think get ready to face a little bit of challenge when it comes to some stuck energy, because I do think it's kind of time to go in a new direction and to really tap into your own abilities to manifest your own reality. So you could be dealing with a Capricorn, Gemini, or Virgo, but I do feel somebody here does have all the tools. I kind of feel this is about the heart with all the roses on the magician, and somebody here has been all trapped up in some outdated beliefs. I think in a prison of their own making, really needing to remove the blindfold to see what's needing to come through, because healing is here. But I think you're going to need to take some swift action. Bottom of the deck, wishes. Nine of Cups, higher level of commitment. Two of Cups. So what are you needing to release that has really prevented you from stepping into a deep spiritual union with another? Where is there this block? Because somebody here is in a toxic relationship or in a toxic situation that really isn't serving them. I think doing a deep dive into some shadow work, I think there's a lot of divine protection when it comes to going deep within these outdated beliefs and patterns. And the central energy really is the magician. So where are you kind of fooling yourself when it comes to stepping into this new experience, when it comes to calling in like-minded souls? And I think that is much needed when it comes to this rejuvenation, because healing is taking place, but I feel you're needing to take that first step. However small that first step is, you're needing to take that first step. And I do think you're going to be taking that first step and going somewhere really, really, really fast. I think breaking free. So I do see Sag and Aries Leo Sag. So let's go a little bit further and see what this devil energy is all about. What can you tell me about this devil energy? We have the Queen of Wands. She's my temptress with the Seven of Swords. Ooh, the Queen of Pentacles and the Tower. Get ready for a major turn of events. I don't think you're going to see it coming. I do feel two energies previously after the Two of Cups was the Three of Cups. So what's coming between you and this soulmate union? Because get ready for a tower. Something's coming in to break you free from a toxic pattern. And I feel with this Queen of Wands, Seven of Swords, we have 777. Get ready, because there is a divinely guided change taking place to get somebody to break free. I'm feeling a sex addiction when it comes to the devil and this Queen of Wands, maybe always chasing after the next shiny thing. I think somebody's been at the crossroads. There's been a lot of deception below the surface. He's got the Five of Swords in his bag and the Two of Swords behind him. So somebody here is going to do whatever it takes to win at all costs. I feel somebody here just wants to fight, and there is a need to gain a new perspective, to gain a sense of enlightenment. We do have a solid, stable, grounded Queen of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. It doesn't have to be, but I think whatever's been hidden below the surface when it comes to some lying and some deceiving, quite possibly even stealing. The Seven of Swords could represent theft. Somebody here is facing some karmic judgment. There is going to be a complete crumbling of a foundation that was built on lies from the start, I feel. So what is this magician? The Knight of Cups, the Six of Pentacles, the Six of Wands. Yeah, somebody here has been fighting, and I think they don't want to fight. There is going to be victory. There is going to be balance. And I think somebody here is manifesting, coming forward with an offer, their cup, an apology, to balance some scales. And I think somebody has been all trapped up in their head trying to figure a way out of a very toxic situation. They've been riddled with lies, and I feel a lot going on below the surface that is needing to be addressed, because there's been a lot of stress, anxiety, sleepless nights, perhaps even like a prison cell type energy. Maybe somebody here is in poor health, could be needing to go to the hospital. But I do feel a lot of mental trickery in the energies, and truth is going to be coming to the surface. This is all about truth, integrity, authenticity, and accountability. And the Queen of Swords is all about accountability. And this Queen of Swords is very purified, I feel, above the fray. She can see above the fray. And there are a lot of emotions here, I feel. And it's kind of time to restore a sense of balance. Somebody here has been given to two. Fighting with somebody, manipulating somebody, really needing to come forward with an apology. There very well could be a water sign. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, that is wanting to balance some scales when it comes to an earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. There is somebody here that has a golden opportunity, and there is a need to release a false foundation in order to bring wishes being granted to the surface and a soulmate union. So get ready for a lot of heated communication. I think there is going to be a revelation when it comes to some betrayal. I was asking about the Knight of Wands, and we got the Eight of Wands, the Five of Wands. So there is like a Three of Wands at play, taking that first step. And I think if somebody finally takes that first step and maybe communicates about a brand new beginning in love, this is big, big love, like holy grail love. It's going to create an argument, I'm feeling, with this Queen of Wands energy. And I do feel there's been some betrayal here, some backstabbing. And somebody here is getting ready to gather their strength to stop fighting. It takes greater strength to stop fighting than to keep feeding the fire, where it just keeps looping round and round. So I do feel Somebody is seeing clearly with their third eye what they need to do to restore a sense of overall well-being in their life. And I do feel, you know, the highest authority is kind of stepping in, bringing forward a divine counterpart union. But there is a need to release something first and foremost. There is a need to leave a third party energy out in the cold. And that is what is in turn going to bring in healing, illumination, better times. So I do think get ready for a realignment. I do feel an exciting offer is coming, and I don't know that you're going to see this coming. So get prepared. We now have Leo and Aquarius here. So there is going to be a celebration once somebody is able to walk away from whatever's kept them stuck in this low vibration energy, whatever's kept them stuck in these old belief patterns. You're definitely going to need to offer forgiveness and clear your head from any mental clutter. That's that Nine of Swords energy coming through, because there is better times ahead, but you're needing to get out of a situation where I think you've spent a lot of time working on it when it's just riddled with everything, you know, untruthful below the surface. I really don't like that Seven of Swords. It really is a theft of some sort, I feel, whether somebody stole something from somebody or just, you know, really deceived somebody and kept them from stepping into a new experience. And I feel that in itself is a theft when somebody maliciously and intentionally keeps somebody stuck in a situation that's needing to be addressed and needing to crumble. So I think trust in your intuition. Somebody here is getting ready to walk away from a very dissatisfying situation, a very unemotional, fulfilling situation. There's a lot of discontent there. And somebody deeply wants to rush in a new direction to bring a sense of balance and healing in their life. So let's see what needs to come through with the Crystal Stone deck when it comes to this message. But 777, I think, a lot of divinely guided movement in the energies, and you're definitely needing to organize your headspace and to kind of get your center in balance again. Find your center. You got to train yourself to focus on, you know, what it is you need to do so you can wipe the slate clean and discern appropriately, because somebody here desperately needs some breathing room to figure out which direction they need to go in to break free from this never-ending onslaught of maliciousness in and around them. I do feel a major reset is coming, because there is somebody here way out of alignment that is needing to kind of square up with the universe and to bring a lot of light and truth forward. Yeah, I feel there's a masculine that's needing to take authority of his life and perhaps is going through a major transformation and looking to find his center to get back into alignment. I do feel somebody went in the direction of something shiny and flashy, and something fishy is here, and there's a need for protection. And I do feel, you know, somebody here is getting ready to live out their heart's desires, to, you know, make that head over heart decision and to go forward, releasing any doubt to restore a sense of balance. And I don't have any Libra energy out here, but it's feeling very Libra-esque. So, you know, sometimes we have to go forward with doubt without a map forward. And, you know, our time here on Earth is precious. So we really should make important decisions when it comes to living our life to the fullest. So what is your heart asking you to do? Because the mind and the heart likely aren't in alignment, needing to be addressed. And I feel spirit is nudging somebody here to do what is best for their heart in order to live out their deepest desires when it does come to a deep spiritual, possibly supernatural connection. So I think get inspired. It's time to speak some truth. It's time to speak clearly and honestly from the heart. And I feel, you know, get ready to receive a message in order to step into some expanded consciousness. Communication. So somebody here is getting ready to manifest their masterpiece. This is a must-have for their life right now, I feel. Somebody has a big idea, a big dream, maybe an epiphany. The judgment is an awakening call. So I feel it's time to really get to the grind. It's time to really clean something up. Whatever this tower is, it's not working. This is a blessing in disguise to get you to clear the pathway to step forward into your true dreams. And that's what I have for a message today. I hope this resonated. If it did and you would like to book a personal reading, please feel free to check out the description box below. I will be continuing on with the monthly readings over the next couple days, so keep an eye out for that. And I look forward to seeing you all again next time. Thank you.